My name is Rodrigo Krugner. I'm a research entomologist with the USDA Agricultural Research Service. Today we're in the San Joaquin Valley Agricultural Science Center in Parlier, California. We're inside a containment facility where we do research with glassy-winged sharpshooters and Pierce disease. The project that we started about a year and a half ago is on glassy-winged sharpshooter bioacoustics, trying to understand how these insects communicate with each other. For the last year or so, we've been working on the identification and characterization of signals produced by these insects when they're communicating with each other. We have identified female calls and male calls, and then also female-female interaction and male-male interaction, mainly territorial behavior. In leafhoppers, sharpshooters, they communicate exclusively via substrate-borne vibrations. They do not use pheromones. These are volatile chemicals. The way they produce their sounds or vibration, they're very small insects. They use the abdominal muscles to vibrate the entire abdomen. This will produce the waves that will be transmitted through the legs to the substrate. If they're feeding on the plant, and glassy-winged sharpshooter does feed when they're producing the sounds, the stylets can also be used as a conductor for the vibration. These are waves, they will travel in the plant as bending waves. And then at the other end, the receiver will listen to these waves or detect the waves using the subgenal and the joint chordotonal organs, which are located in the leg somewhere right here in the elbows. Sometimes they have these scintillas all over their body. We don't know yet for glassy-winged sharpshooter. We're still investigating how they produce, how they exactly produce these sounds, and how they receive these sounds. Mm-hmm. What we have here in this setup is the laser Doppler vibrometer shooting at the plant, and that's what we use to record the signals produced by the sharpshooter. These black device over here is an electrodynamic shaker, which is basically a speaker, and that's what we use to deliver sounds or vibrations to the plant through the stinger here. So it's basically a speaker with a membrane, but to deliver the vibrations to the plant, we use the stinger, which is just touching the plant. There is a sharpshooter up here on this plant, and we're trying to communicate with her. So this is an experimental device. We're now looking into making less expensive devices and more durable that we can take out to vineyards and start playing back these signals to wires used in vineyard trellis. So we did all the experiments. Last year, we have identified and characterized a number of glassy-winged sharpshooter signals. These are vibrational signals used in their communication. The next phase of the project, that's when we're gonna start doing playback experiments and with hopes of identifying signals that could be used to disrupt their communication, jam their communication system, attract them, or repel them. And that will be done in the field conditions by playing back signals in wires using vineyard trellis.